Hello friends, my name is Mohsin Mulla and I welcome you to this another video lecture on Unit2 Industrial Instrumentation of Industrial Automation and Control subject. So the topic today we are going to discuss is measurement of level, humidity and pH. Level, humidity and pH are three important process parameters, and their measurement find wide applications in chemical and manufacturing industries. So as we know that in beverages industry, as we usually drink the soft drinks, they need to have a proper value of pH so that it is not harmful to the digestion system of the human. Therefore, it is very much essential to maintain the pH value to the standards set by the authorities, okay, which are healthy for the people. So for that, it is continuously required to monitor the pH value of the beverages. So there it is required. Similarly, in most of the industries also, we need to maintain the level of the liquid in the boilers or in the drums at a particular level to obtain a certain pressure. So that needs to be continuously monitored. Therefore, here in this particular case, measurement of level of the liquid or pH value of the liquid or also the humidity in certain places, like if we say there is a textile industry or there is a paper industry where humidity plays a vital role in maintaining the quality of the textiles or the paper. If there is a humid environment, in that case it may deteriorate the quality of the paper that we are expecting to come out of that industry. So therefore, we need to also monitor the humidity in certain industrial places. Therefore, in this particular unit or topic, we are going to discuss the different ways in which we can measure these three important parameters, that is level, humidity and pH. So first, let us consider the level measurement. There are several instances where we need to monitor the liquid level in vessels. In some cases, the problem is simple, so we need to monitor the level, water level of a tank. A simple float type of mechanism is sufficient to monitor the water level. But sometimes the whatever liquid we want to measure, level of the liquid we want to measure, it is usually in a sealed container. So directly it is not visible at what level the liquid is. Therefore, and sometimes the liquid might be a combustible like a petrochemical product, so which cannot be just exposed to the environment, and hence it needs to be in the sealed container. Therefore, we need to measure the fluid level continuously. Like in our vehicles also, there will be a fuel indicator which works on the principle of this level measurement. Okay, so depending upon the complexity of the situation, there are different methods used for the measuring of the liquid level. So those methods are, first one, the most basic one is the float type. Okay, then there is a hydrostatic differential pressure gauge type. Then third one is capacitance type. Then next, fourth one is ultrasonic type, where sound is used. Then there is finally a radiation technique, which is also used in some of the packaging techniques for bottle filling. Okay, so now let us consider first the hydrostatic differential pressure type. The hydrostatic pressure developed at the bottom of a tank is given by pressure P equal to H into rho into G, where H is the height of the liquid level and rho is the density of the liquid. So by putting the two pressure tappings, one at the bottom and the other at the top of the tank, we can measure the differential pressure. Now, which can be calibrated in terms of the liquid level. As we know, simple way that if there is more and more level of the water in a certain container, in that case there will be a rise in the pressure, so that will directly give the differential pressure. So one pressure is measured at the top level and another one is at the bottom level. So as much pressure difference is available, depending upon that value, we can directly estimate how much level of the liquid is available in the tank. So this is here what is mentioned. So one is measured at this level, another one is measured at this level. So the two pressure gauges are used, one at the top and another one at the bottom. So these two pressure gauges will continuously monitor the pressure, and the difference is obtained in this way. So this will give us the direct pressure difference between the two pressure tappings, which is a direct indication of the water level or the liquid level of whatever sort of the liquid is present in that container. Okay, so next is capacitance type. This type of sensors are widely used for chemical and photochemical industries and can be used for a wide range of temperatures like minus 40 degree to 200 degrees Celsius and pressures ranging from 25 to 60 kg per centimeter square. It uses a coaxial type cylinder and the capacitance is measured between the inner rod and the outer cylinder as it is shown in the figure next. The total capacitance of the two terminal will be the sum of the capacitance of the insulating bushing, capacitance of the air and liquid vapor, then the capacitance due to the liquid. So these capacitance will give rise to a particular value of the capacitance which directly indicates the level of the liquid. Now, if the total capacitance is measured when the tank is empty, in that case, this value will be equal to C. So, finding these three together when the tank is completely empty will get usually the value of capacitance as C1. And next value of the capacitance or the total capacitance when the tank is filled with liquid is obtained as Ct, which is given by this formula here. Ct is equal to the first value of the capacitance at the empty condition. Then there is second value of the capacitance which is obtained when there is a level of the liquid with a certain height h, okay, so which can be shown in this figure here. So when there is a liquid level h available here, in that case the capacitance of the cylindrical area is going to change, and that capacitance is obtained when the when this tank is empty. In that case, that h is equal to zero, so therefore this value equal to zero when the tank is empty, so we'll get directly only this C1 value. But when the tank is filling with the liquid, in that case the h is going to rise. As the h is going to rise, so this is the formula. This basic form is for the cylinder, you can say coaxial type of cable capacitor, okay, or coaxial cylinder, cylindrical capacitor, where there are two radiuses. One is radius R1, another one is the radius R2 from the center. And if you want to obtain the capacitance between these two, then this is the formula used to obtain that capacitance, where E1, epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 are the permittivities. One is the permittivity of the liquid and E2 is the permittivity of the air or liquid vapor, which is equal to, usually which is equal to, considered as 1. Hence, a linear relationship can be obtained with the liquid level. Therefore, whenever there is a rise in the liquid level, so as we know this is a constant, there will be rise in this particular value, and rise in this particular value will directly indicate the level. So this way we can also measure the level of the liquid present in the container. So ultrasonic type of this level measuring instrument. So here basically one transmitter will be there, and there will be one receiver placed in the bottom of the container. So this will generate a sound wave which will travel, and it will just reflect back from the interface between the air empty space and the surface of the liquid. So depending upon the distance here, that is the height of the liquid level, so there will be delay in the you can say that sound wave coming back to the receiver. So here it is directly going to measure the time travel, time required to travel the sound wave from the transmitter to receiver. So ideally when it is not having any value, at that time we can take the time as zero, but as soon as the level is increasing, in that case the time required for sound wave to travel back to the receiver will increase, and it will directly give us the value of the level, because here this T will be directly proportional to H, which is a linear linear type of relationship. Hence we'll be able to measure the level of the liquid by using this ultrasonic type of measuring instrument. Next is radiation type. So here radioactive technique is used, okay, so in the measurement of level in the sealed containers. So here radioactive wave usually gets attenuated when it passes through a medium. Okay, so radioactive ray usually transmitted in the empty space like vacuum, then it travels with a normal, you can say, magnitude and speed. But as soon as it enters into a medium, then its magnitude starts attenuated, it gets suppressed. And as the magnitude level will be higher, in that case, there will be higher attenuation. And here this attenuation can be obtained like this, with the help of this particular formula here, where x will give us the direct level of the you can say level of the liquid present in the container. So this exponential term is directly reducing type of exponential function. So therefore, when there is no level at that time, the wave will travel with the highest intensity. But as soon as level of the liquid will increase, in that case the attenuation constant value will also start playing the role, and it will take the value of I naught lower and lower as the level is increasing. As x is increasing, so in that case this value of I of x is going to decrease, and that is, that decrement is directly an indication of the level of the liquid present in the container. So here this is obtained with the help of this type of, you can say, arrangement. Here directly a wave is transmitted from the top of the, and there will be you can say counter available at this particular point, so which will directly count the magnitude of the whatever ray we are transmitting. So therefore, when the liquid content is, liquid level is higher and higher, at that time the magnitude of the transmitted radioactive ray will gets attenuated, it becomes lower and lower. So that will directly indicate us the level here. So this will directly indicate the level, okay, which is afloat. And this kind of technique is usually used in the bottle filling. So in case of a bottle filling, so the bottle needs to be filled, or the container needs to be filled at a certain level. So here continuously two, one receiver and one transmitter of the radioactive wave will be placed. So these are in continuous, we can say without obstruction, they are continuous in contact. But as soon as the level of the liquid starts filling up, so these, when it reaches to this level, so this will sense the decrease in the radioactive wave, which will directly indicate the bottle is filled, and the whatever the power will there, it will stop its operation when the level is reached, and next bottle will start filling up. So this kind of process requires this level measuring technique. Okay, so next is the humidity measurement. Humidity measurement finds wide application in different process industries. So moisture in the atmosphere must be controlled below a certain level. Okay, like in, also we can observe the same type of analysis in our houses also. When we want to preserve some food grains, we need to dry the grains in sun so that the humidity level in the water content in the grains is reduced to the nominal level. If they are left in the humid environment, in that case the cereals or grains are going to get destroyed by fungus and all. So likewise, most of the processes will also are, you can say, directly exposed to fungus or different type of deterioration due to presence of the humidity in the environment, which is harmful for the products. Therefore, it is very much essential to control the humidity also in the environment. Therefore, it is necessary to measure the humidity. So now there are different ways in which the humidity can be expressed. So one is the absolute humidity, then there is a relative humidity, and there is a dew point. So absolute humidity, in the sense when there is a humid environment, there is a, suppose, wood block. So when there is a humid environment, in that case the wood block is going to get expanded in both the directions, in all the directions. That expansion is directly going to give us the measure of the humidity present. Okay, so that is called as the absolute humidity. And in case of relative humidity, so here with the help of hygrometer, that can be directly measured. So hygroscopic nature means the material will directly absorb the humidity from the air. So such materials are wood, hair, then paper, etc., are sensitive to humidity. So even our hair will feel like, you can say, kind of they will contain the moisture kind of content. Okay, and they will become like bundles of hairs together. So when there is a humid environment outside, okay, so therefore and that is also direct measure of the humidity, presence of the humidity. Okay, so hair becoming sticky. Then the temperature difference between to measure the relative type of relative humidity. So we'll make use of another type of methodology, that is here dry bulb and wet bulb can be used to measure the humidity directly, as the temperature on the wet bulb will be different than the temperature on the dry bulb, which are exposed in the same environment. So that will also give us the direct measurement of the humidity. So that is the relative humidity. Now there is a dew point measurement. So also sometimes humidity will be so large that the drop dew, that environment will be having dew formation on the surfaces like glasses and like wax surfaces like leaves and all. So that is called as dew point measurement. Okay, so there is a kind of a method to measure the dew point. Okay, so if gas is cooled at a certain pressure to the dew point, condensation of vapor will start. Okay, so vapor will not be present in the form of gas, but it will accumulate as a droplet of water, which is called as a dew. Okay, so which is usually observed in the morning time on surfaces of the leaves and glasses. Okay, as temperature starts rising, the dew droplets will start melting and they will again become like vapors. Okay, so that kind of situation is called as a dew point. Okay, and here optical detection method is used to measure the dew point formation. Okay, then conductance and capacitance method of measurement. So many solid absorb moisture and their values of conductance and capacitance, and also in some cases resistances will change. Now the change in conductance and change in capacitance can also directly lead us to the existence of humidity level in the environment they are exposed to. Moisture content in granules changes the capacitance between the two electrodes plates placed inside. Suppose there is a kind of material placed in the atmosphere and it is containing some type of known granules, okay, and they are now exposed to the environment. Okay, so now we are measuring continuously the capacitance between the two granules. So now capacitance is nothing but, so whatever you can say, this dielectric is trying to store the energy applied from these two capacitor plates. Now depending upon the, you can say, dielectric property of this granules here. Okay, so these are the granules. Okay, some material, dielectric metal put so in the form of small pieces. So now when they are dry, at that time the, you can say, dielectric property of that metal will be very high. So they are acting as a very good dielectric metal. In that case the capacitance may be very high, but as soon as moisture content in the atmosphere starts affecting these granules due to humidity, then due to moisture content here, the dielectric property of this material inside will start deteriorating, which will lead to decrease in the direct opposition for that electric stress. So capacitance value will start decreasing in this case. So this will directly give us the measure of existence of the humidity level in the atmosphere. Same way conductance can be used, as we know that wet wood is a very good conductor, dry wood is a very good insulator. So that is also a direct measure. If the flow of leakage current in the wood is larger and larger, or in such type of material, if current is made to flow through this material, if it is dry, in that case leakage current will be very small. If it is wet, or you can say moist, in that case the leakage current will be higher, and that will directly give us to the humidity present in the environment it is exposed to. Okay, then we can take the measures to control the humidity of the environment, like by turning on the AC, the air will become very dry. Okay, so that is one way to make the air dry. Similarly, we can start the cooler, which will make the air little bit humid. Okay, so that is also possible. So depending upon our requirement, we can adjust the level of humidity by using different applications of different equipment. Now here is, next is the measurement of pH. Now pH is a very important, you can say, parameter, needs to be measured in most of the industries handling liquid form of products. Like chemical industries are there, like beverage industries are there, like alcohol industries are there, which need to continuously monitor the pH value of the liquid they are processing. Okay, and we know that pH is nothing but it is the scale on which we can measure the nature of the liquid. Okay, so here exactly 7, and here it is from 1. Okay, and here at maximum it can go up to 14. So this is called as a pH scale. Okay, so now basically if any liquid forms between 1 to 7, at that time it will be acidic in nature. Okay, so that we already know from the chemistry classes at the our SSC level. Then similarly, if any liquid falls under this particular 7 to 14 value, and at that time it will be alkaline type of material. Okay, so now exactly at 7, so this is the pH value of the water. Okay, so it is exactly the pH value of the water. Now what is pH value? Presence of hydrogen ion in the liquid is called as the pH value. Okay, so now here measurement of the pH is nothing but the measurement of directly the presence of hydrogen ions here. So pH value of the water is calculated. So for this we need to go a little bit into basics of the chemistry formulae in order to understand the calculation of the pH. But for an example, it can be just considered here that pH is like equal to 7 for the water, as hydrogen ions are 10 raised to minus 7 gram per liter at 25 degree in the water. So that is the standard value available concentration of the water, or the concentration of the hydrogen ions present in the water per liter. Okay, so likewise for other liquids also it will be known. So using that we can determine, or we can also determine the this particular value, concentration value, which will can be directly used in this formula to find out the pH value of the liquid. Okay, so here pH scale is very helpful to determine the value of the pH. Okay, so we know that when the pH value comes in a particular range, at that time we can decide whether this is a alkaline in nature, whether it is acidic in nature, or it is just a normal, or you can say neutral kind of liquid. The here the method is this value can be also measured by using two electrodes here. So one electrode is called as the reference electrode and another one is called as the measuring electrode. So now basically the reference electrode is a single cell, and measuring electrodes are two half cells. So it is like they will act as two half cells. Now depending upon the hydrogen concentration in the liquid, the measuring electrode will measure the value of the potential, and also the reference electrode will measure the value of the potential, and essentially we will be able to get the potential difference, and that potential difference will directly lead us to the calculation of the pH value. So here one formula is given for the measurement of that EMF by using the half cells. Okay, so here it is a bit kind of a more technical formula, so we need not to go in much detail about it. So only we need to highlight here the types of, can say, measuring ways for different parameters which are required to be measured in different processing industries. Thank you.